Assalamualaikum students, I want you to open your maths textbook page number 221 and today we are going to start the last unit which is picture graphs. Okay, open page number 222. I'm going to explain. Let's read. These are Timothy's toys. Count the number of toys he has. Now, how we are going to read a picture graph? First of all, what is a picture graph? Okay. If you have some things, for example, if you have a set of books and you have a set of notebooks and you also have a set of geometry boxes or pencils. Let's say you have four books, you have three notebooks and you have two geometry boxes. So you're going to arrange them in order. That is sometimes known as a picture graph. How? Let me show you. Look over here. Here we are going to add books. Then we are going to add notebook. And there we have pencil case. We are going to make columns and we are going to put up notebooks and notebooks. For example, this is book 1, this is book 2, book 3 and notebooks. Let's say notebook 1 and notebook 2 and pencil case 1 and 2. So now if these are your things, you can say I have 3 books, I have 2 notebooks and I have 2 pencil cases. This is how you arrange your stuff. You can take pictures of such things and then you can make a table. So in this way, you know what, you can make a picture graph yourself. Now look on page 222. Here they are, we have a number of toys. These are Timothy's toys. And if we will count them and we can arrange them, then that can be a picture graph. We can make a picture graph out of it. Look, he has toy soldiers, he has toy cars and teddy bears. Okay, now count all these things. Good. If you have counted on the pages, now look on the page number 223. He has 3 teddy bears. Look, we have 3 teddy bears. We've sorted them out into teddy bears from here. Then he has 6 toy cars. We have sorted from the page and we have them in one column. Then he has 8 toy soldiers. Now here we have 8 toy soldiers. We can arrange Timothy's toys in this way. This is called a picture graph. As I explained earlier, this is how you make a picture graph when you arrange same things into one column. Okay. Now, in this way, you are going to do page number 224. These are Maheen's pets, parrot, goldfish, rabbit. Now, under this, there are some questions and you are going to simply answer that. How many parrots does Maheen have? How many rabbits she has? Simple things like that. There are simple counting questions and you're going to do it yourself. Okay, page number 224, page number 225, 226, 227. It is very simple and you're going to do it yourself. Okay? Look. This is page number 227. This graph shows the number of jellies 4 children have. We have children Jane, Mary, Tom and Mark. Jane has 2 jellies, Mary has 3, Tom has 1 and Mark has 4. Okay? There are the jellies that they eat. Now, there at the bottom there are questions. How many jellies did Jane eat? How many jellies did Mark eat? How many more than he eat? And how do you find out more and less? If there are 4 jellies for Mark, it's an example, and there are 2 jellies for Tom, then how are you gonna find out how many more did Mark eat? How are you going to do it? You're going to subtract. 4 minus 2 is equals to 2, which means Mark had 2 more jellies than Tom. And if you're going to ask how less, simple, same thing goes for them. Okay, so you're going to do these pages on your own. Now open page number 229. First of all, you've been told to read a picture graph, that you can have, that you have columns and there are pictures in it and you know how much thing belongs to someone, right? But to now you're going to learn to make your own picture graph. Look, this is page number 229. Lala picked 15 balls from a bag. How many balls did she pick? 15, containing 4 different colored. Now, in a bag, there were 15 balls and they were in different colors. What colors? They were in red, yellow, blue and green. Okay, 15 balls of these different colors. She used cross to stand for each ball she has picked. and drew from the picture and drew the picture graph below. Okay, so what she did is, look again. Here we have red, blue, yellow, green. Okay, for example, if I had from the bag 3 red balls, I will put 3 cross for 3 red balls. Let's say I have 5 blue balls, I will put 5 cross. Again, this is an example, not the book context. I'm showing just as an example. Okay, and if we got only 1 yellow ball, a yellow ball cross, and then if we got 2 green, then 2 crosses. So this is how you can make your own picture graph. Now you know that how many balls you had, how many of them were red, how many were blue, how many were yellow, and how many you had green balls. Okay, this is how you can make your own picture graph. Understood? Now on this page, John threw a dice 15 times. You know what a dice is, right? There's a picture as well. What were the numbers that came? 1 2 times, 2 4 times, 4 2 times, and 5 1 time. Using tick to stand for one throw, complete the following picture graph. Now how are we going to make it? Let's make a rough one over here because I'm not going to show you my book. It is 1 2 3 4 5 6. Okay, I'm just making it. Let's see. 1 uska, how many times it came? 2 times. So we're going to put 2 ticks in 1. Okay, now 4 times. 2 uska kitne times aaya tha? 4 times. Here we have 2. Let's put 4 ticks. 2 3 4. Okay, 3 times. 1 2 3. It is made on your book. You have to solve your book page, but I am just making an example of it. Okay, now 4 2 times. Here we have 4. 1 2. 5 1 time. 5 1 time. And then 6 3 times. 1 2 3. So this is how you make a simple picture graph. Understood? Good.